Hello Galaxy Commanders and welcome back to the next video about alliances in Infinite Galaxy. As promised, today or now we are going to take over our star platform. So if you didn't see the last video, you should take a look. And we already reserved the platform there by just clicking on it and challenging it. So the time is getting close now for this platform. You see it starts in 4 seconds. You should make sure that everyone in your alliance is getting their fleet close if they are not already in the system. And then as soon as the event starts, you have 45 minutes to take it over. You can click on it, you will see what you get, the alliance taxes, the resources you get, and also the planets that are in the system. The process itself is very simple. You just send your fleet to attack. So the thing is, if you have Discord or another voice chat, using this voice chat will help you a lot to make sure that everyone attacks at the same time. If not, what I saw with some alliances, or also when we are lazy and don't want to join Discord, we just use the progress timer. So we go into our alliance chat and we say attack at, let's say, 43:45. Okay, maybe you do it with the right caps lock, then you send it and everyone knows it. So at 43:45, you click the attack button and you send your fleet in there. If you all got your fleets close to the platform, they will get in there all around the same time, and you should be able to build up enough power to take over this platform. Very likely, it depends how early you're in the game. Also, different levels of platform will have different strengths. So I chose the Star Platform 3 because it's not so high in power, and also this one gives me a resource gathering buff, which is really nice. So this buff will be active for all the players in the alliance, no matter where they are, as long as the system is connected to your HQ. So now, as soon as you finished and won the star platform, it starts with a timer. This timer shows you that you now have to take it over. So at the moment it's temporarily occupied, it's not mine yet. So you click the build button and click build. We don't have an alliance HQ yet, so we just have to say okay. And we want to build an alliance HQ. And this will make this our HQ. The first HQ doesn't cost you any reserves. That is good because we don't have anything yet. And when this is done, you have to place fleets inside there to be able to build. And you can see there is a fleet limit that you can place inside there. Can I see this again? Here we are. Of 70,000 leadership. So send as many fleets inside there. This will give you also additional alliance honor. And the more leadership you got inside, the more fleets you got inside, the faster the building will be. More alliance member and fleet will make the building speed even faster. You can only send one fleet per commander there. And now you have to wait. So we have to wait till we finish building our alliance headquarter. As soon as you got your alliance headquarter, you might want to get additional systems. You can look around if there's another system close by this buff. So as you see, I don't have any system close by with any buff available. We already occupy the system we are building at the moment. The next system would be over here. It's a level 4 star platform. I'm not sure if I will be able to do it alone, but we will just try it. So same thing again. We challenge it, we choose the time within the next 24 hours when we want to challenge it. The server time is 3:05, so I can reserve it for like in around an hour or in 2 hours. I will go for, let's check how long we will need for building this, 45 minutes. Yeah, I think we can do it in the next hour then. And we will see how that works. So we just challenge it at 4. You can also change it to 4:10 if you want. You click the reserve. And now the star platform is reserved for you at this time. If another alliance is reserving the platform before you and is occupying it, that's bad luck. So you should keep this in mind when you later go like into areas that are yeah, more interesting for a lot of alliances and where the alliances start fighting over special systems because they have very strong buffs. But when you're in the Outer Ring on a new server, very likely you will have the choice from quite a few systems. This is getting a problem more later in the game when there are most systems. Like if you look at our map here, I had to search for a place that was not yet occupied. It needs a little bit time to build up, but you will see all these systems, they are all occupied. There's not really much left free, and especially when you go to the middle area, to the inner ring, to the center, these are the hard-fought for systems because of the high resources and the big buffs you get with these systems. Hello, Galaxy Commanders, and welcome back to another Infinite Galaxy video. In the last video, we occupied our first platform and built our HQ. When the HQ is finished, don't forget to take out your fleet. You can just click on reinforcement and recall your fleet. So now we got our HQ here. We do get our daily income, and most important, we do have this buff here for all players in the alliance. Next thing we are now going to do is we are going to get the next system, and we already reserved the system directly next to our HQ. If you have a system, let's say maybe here, as long as the system doesn't have a buff, it doesn't matter, then you don't need to connect them. But if the system has a buff, there's no system with buff here. So let's see, here the system would have a buff, it doesn't belong to me. Here you get 12% laser attack. This buff will only be active if the system is connected to your main system. So if I would like to get this buff, I would need to get this system 40-40, 40-38, and then I can connect 40-41. You cannot take over these systems. They are fixed, so the stronghold will never be able to be yours. That means the other way around would go all the way here to the right, which is also possible. So you could take 40-45, 40-27, 58, 44, 42, and 49 to connect the system if you want to have it because of the buff. But if the system doesn't have a buff, it's not so critical. So yeah, we already reserved this platform and we will start very soon. Okay, so we will send out our fleet now to the system. One thing to note is also that you can only reserve one platform at a time. So even if you want to take over multiple systems, you always have to do it one by one. Okay, so 5 minutes before the event starts, you get the event timer and you can see the time counting down. This is the time when you should make sure that you already got your fleets close by to avoid any delay. You got 45 minutes to do this. Okay, so here the countdown goes, 3, 2, 1, and we can start. We don't have to wait for anyone. I'm not even sure if we will be able to do it, but let's just try it. So level 4 platform got 6 million power. That's quite a bit higher than what I can get with one of my fleets. So it is very well possible that we will lose this fight. But yeah, where would be the fun if we don't even try it? So let's see what happens. Okay, so here we are. We did lose the fight, and we can attack it directly again. Okay, so here our fleet comes back, and the star platform is at 2.1 million. Okay, I'm surprised. So that will make it easy for me to take over the whole galaxy, I guess. That means you do have 45 minutes to run as many tries as you want. I would say even if you're a little bit slow, you can do at least like 5 attacks, 4 to 5 attacks. So as long as your starport is close by the star platform you want to take over, you can run multiple attacks, get repaired in between to take over the star platform and make it yours. So, same thing as before, we now have 10 minutes time to occupy the star platform to build an outpost here. We would be connected with the Alliance headquarters, so this is good. And we can either transfer the Alliance headquarters there or we build a new outpost. If we want to transfer, we will lose the other one, so we are just going to build an outpost, but I need 600 Alliance resources. So now this is where it gets really important. You were looking at these points before. Every time you go into your Alliance tech, you can donate here and you get points for this. So the Alliance will gather these points here as an Alliance reserve, and for building up another platform you need 600 points. So that means I would now either need to donate Corium, and if I donate Corium you can see I get 10 points. So to get to 600 points I need to do this 60 times, and the first time was 15, the second time it's 20. So that is quite a lot. 600 points, 60 times, that's 1200 corium. The other option is to reset the cooldown here, but this costs you also 400 corium. You guys are worth a lot to me, but I don't really need this platform at the moment. I will take it over sometime later when I have enough Alliance points for this. The other option is I could now transfer my HQ. It is in this system at the moment, and I could select bringing it to Kocha. So to do this, I don't have any cost for this, and I just click OK. The building will lose some HP and I can repair it. So for now I don't have any cost. I can just move it over here. And the good thing is I don't have to build it, I just have to repair it, even if it says building. So I can send my fleet in there again. And now I have a higher level Alliance headquarter. Important to note is I did lose my system here, the 4050, which had the buff for the buff for the gathering speed. So here we had the 11% gathering speed, and you see in 9 minutes I will lose this platform because I'm not able to build another headquarter there. Or outpost. So even if I would send in My fleet, I still need these 600 alliance points. There's no way around this. We just saw that we got a few additional points there. I think this is from gathering the resources. I don't know if we can see this in the logs or anywhere. Let's check. Invite alliance log. No, we can see the things we did, that we reserved, that we seized control and that we attacked, but we don't see how much points we got and where we got them. So yeah, if you want to have multiple systems, you need to force your members to donate. The faster and the more they donate, the quicker you will be able to get these points, and when you get these points, then you can build more platforms also. I think this makes sense. At the same time, when you... Oh, that was wrong. We want to continue repairing here. At the same time, when you do donate to your alliance, you will also get these additional buffs. So keep in mind that you can choose, like for me, I would prefer probably to choose some cruiser attack. If you get this up, you get 1% additional cruiser attack. This does not sound much, but over time, this will be 5 or 10% additional attack, and this really stacks up. So at the end, these buffs can be pretty strong. They will give you quite a lot of additional power, and yeah, then you can also upgrade the alliance if you have enough alliance points. But before you upgrade it, I would recommend you to get your systems occupied and ready, and then when you're at the limit, start thinking about upgrading it. So yeah, I hope this video explained you a little bit more about the alliance and how the system with the platforms work, what you can do, how you can do it. The next video I will make will be probably about the Stargates, so how to get from the outer ring to the inner ring, and also the fortresses that can give you the strongholds, that can give you some really nice rewards, as you can see here. So I hope you liked it. If you have any feedback, as always, write it in the comment section. I'm always happy to see what you think about the videos and also to get your feedback. Feel free to ask questions if you have any. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. See you later on the next video.